Episode 650, five major elements of a STEAM mindset.
Welcome to the 10-Minute Teacher Podcast, hosted by author, educator, speaker, and mom, the cool cat teacher, Vicki Davis. In times of crisis and change, we could all use a little STEAM power in our classrooms, whether we're teaching online or in person. So we've titled this episode, Five Major Elements of a STEAM Mindset, featuring New York artist, writer, performer, and educator Tim Needles. Tim has been teaching art and media for over 20 years, and his work is known throughout media outlets and museums around the country. He is the recipient of the ISTE Technology in Action Award, the ISTE Creativity Award, the National Art Educators Association AET Outstanding Teaching Award, and the Robert Rauschenberg Power of Art Award at the National Gallery of Art. You're going to love this fun conversation with Vicki and Tim. Enjoy!
In today's socially challenging times, teaching kids how to build social, emotional learning skills can be tough. If you're an educator looking for ways to integrate SEL into your lessons or a parent supporting learning at home, the Allstate Foundation and we are committed to providing you with the resources you need to get started at we.org/SEL. Stay tuned at the end of the show to learn more about this sponsor. So today we're talking with Tim Needles, artist, writer, performer, and educator from New York. He's the author of STEAM Power, Infusing Art into Your STEM Curriculum from ISTE Books. Tim, today we're going to talk about five major elements of the STEAM mindset. Where do we start?
Well, the most important thing for me is creativity. That's one of the things that made me write this book in the first place. As an artist, I have a really deep understanding of creativity, but I find that a lot of people kind of misunderstand it and associate it with art, specifically drawing. And I hear just a lot of students, teachers, parents say, like, I'm not creative. And, you know, I believe everyone can be creative. So it's all about changing your mindset and really understanding what creativity is, which is just approaching something differently. It's a skill that you could build. I think that creative thinking is so important. And when you infuse that into especially STEM curriculum, it's so helpful because that's where the real innovation happens. So, you know, I like to bring a lot of different creative exercises in, and a lot of the lessons that I include in the book are all really based in producing creativity.
If you're just doing STEM and it's just a bunch of kits where you're just following step 1, 2, 3, you can miss out on the creativity. Now, some people start there and then move into creativity, but I think this is a really important piece that you've mentioned, Tim, that we need creativity as part of STEM and STEAM.
Yeah, you know, and it could be challenging. That's one of the things about being creative is that it's not always necessarily easy. Sometimes it takes some thought and it takes a number of different tries to get it right, but it's always worthwhile. That's the important thing to remember.
What's our second one, Tim?
So the next one would be design. So, you know, as an artist, a lot of people have an idea of what art is, but they don't really appreciate how important design is. You know, everything that we wear, everything that we own is designed, and infusing that design and especially design thinking, which has become a new push, certainly in education, centering it on empathy rather than just design is important. Even just a classroom setting, like when you're teaching, you know, does the design of your classroom really help students learn? And you can kind of take that and make that a lesson itself. You know, like I like to redesign my classroom to make sure that it's really fitting the students that I'm working with. So design is something that you can incorporate into anything that you're teaching. It doesn't matter. It doesn't need to be art. It doesn't even need to be STEM. Design is a major part of just being alive today in the world.
And even just taking a moment to go, wow, I love the design of that keychain, or I love the design of that hat, and just pointing out that design is really something that improves our lives in having beautiful things around us.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, like, good design really makes a difference. I mean, we all know from, you know, our own homes and our own classrooms and our cars, you know, there's some things that are well designed and they make your life easier and they're just more comfortable. So incorporating that sort of design mentality and that design thinking into your lessons is really going to make a big difference.
Okay, what's our third?
The third one is curiosity. So as an artist, that's certainly where most of your work comes from, is your own curiosity, but also encouraging students to find their curiosities. And a lot of that comes into modeling and sharing what you're curious about and how you follow your curiosities. But that's usually the center, and that's where STEAM intersects really well. So scientists are curious in a similar way than artists. You know, there's a similar process that they follow. So it's all about really focusing on your creativity and students' creativity and helping them get the courage and the permission to follow that.
Okay, what's our fourth?
The fourth one is important and it's a tough one. It's failure. We often look at failure shamefully, and I think it's really important to learn from your mistakes and to embrace failure. There's no one that succeeds without failing a lot. Failure is really an essential one to take a look at, because understanding failure and understanding how to think about failure and embrace it is so important. Failure is one of those things that we have shame about, but it's important to actually change the way we think about it and see it as just part of the creative process. So embracing failure and actually owning it makes a really big difference in student learning.
You know, something my husband has always said to our children when they fail is, what have you learned? Because if you have learned, it's not the same. True failure is when you make a mistake and you learn nothing and you repeat it. But if you learn something, then you've gotten something out of it.
That's so true. I mean, like, really, you know, you learn so much more from your failures than you do from your successes. And that's why you really need to embrace that and, you know, just own it in the same way that you're talking about.
Yeah. Okay, what's our fifth?
The fifth one is my favorite, and it's fun. So this is something that some teachers are a little bit hesitant to bring into the classroom, but I really believe in fun as a way to engage learning and to really use STEAM in the most appropriate way in the classroom. And certainly students are engaged by aspects of fun. And, you know, science can be fun, art can be fun, engineering can be fun, technology. I love playing with new ed tech. You know, it's amazing. So, like, not just having fun, but showing students that you have fun, modeling that sense of fun for them and allowing them to have fun and letting it be okay in the classroom. I think that's huge.
So the book is STEAM Power, Infusing Art into Your STEM Curriculum by Tim Needles. And I think these are five very important mindsets that should be part of any STEAM learning that's going on in our schools. Thanks, Tim. In today's challenging times, we know how critical it is to make sure kids are equipped with social and emotional learning skills to cope with the world around them. That's why I'm excited to highlight today's sponsor, the We Schools program, made possible by the Allstate Foundation. It brings social and emotional learning together with service learning, helping children build key skills such as resilience, empathy, perseverance, and problem solving. Whether you're an educator looking for ways to integrate SEL into your lesson planning or a parent looking to support your kids' remote learning at home, go to we.org/SEL for helpful educational resources and tips. Our friends at the Allstate Foundation and we are committed to providing you with the resources you need to get started. Thanks, we and the Allstate Foundation, for sponsoring this podcast episode.